Hi, this is Jessica. Right now I have a Chromebook in front of me. It's an HP touchscreen Chromebook, about 13 or 14 inches, and the screen is set at 100%. There's no zoom at the moment. And what I want to look at is the use of the touchscreen for learning activities in the classroom. I'm on a website, IXL, and it has activities in math, language arts, and other subjects. This website I see used a lot in classrooms. So let me go ahead and look for a lesson to do here. And I can use my Control Plus to make the website contents bigger if I go back to 100%. The other thing that we can do with the touchscreen is the pinch gestures on the touchscreen work like Control Plus, which is used to just increase the size of the web page contents. It's not increasing the size of the tabs or anything else. For that, you use Control Shift Plus or the magnifier. But right now, I'm going to pinch in here to zoom in and find, let's read match analog and digital clocks. So since I have a touchscreen, I can just tap that. And it's loading. And what I'm thinking about with the touchscreen is it's very intuitive for kids to touch answers, tap to answer, or to use the pinch gestures to zoom in and out. So for younger kids, a touchscreen might be an option that a TVI would look at. So this webpage has a speaker button so a student can listen to the instructions, and that's easy to just tap.
Look at the analog clock.
So if they were using the mouse, that might be take a little bit longer. Of course, they're learning to do that, but the option to just tap it.
Look at the analog clock.
Is nice. Also, we could quickly zoom in and zoom back out. Of course, your student is learning to control plus and minus. That takes, you know, looking at the keyboard. So maybe this is a quick option for them. And then on this page, they need to match the analog clock, which says 3. And then we have two prompts here, potential answers, 4 o'clock and 3 o'clock in a digital clock form.
Which digital clock shows the same time?
So if needed, they could zoom in quickly with a pinch, and they could tap to select their answer. Go back. I selected without tapping which one. So it shows 3 o'clock. I'm going to tap that one, and now there's a blue box around it, and I hit submit. And then I get my next question. So that's a quick look at how a touchscreen might be beneficial for a student.